Hidden sugars are sabotaging your weight loss. There is no doubt that excess sugar in the body forms into stored fat and creates havoc to other organs of the body. Sugar, especially fructose, is bad for health. No more questions about this fact. What complicates and aggravates the horrors of sugar is the industry's desperate effort to subtly infuse their sugar products into our food. Researchers say that today's obesity crisis may be linked to the sugar added to foods in the late 1970s. Sweeteners added to children's drinks at that time may have also set their taste buds to prefer sugary items. The researchers also say this phenomenon is stronger in low-income neighborhoods, where processed foods and sugar-infused items are more common. The recent study, published in the journal Economics and Human Biology, traces the modern obesity epidemic back to baby formula in the 1970s. It suggests the dietary habits learned by children 40 years ago could explain today's adult obesity crisis. Another similar study on the effects of high fructose consumption in the midst of a high-fat, high-calorie diet prevalent in modern world, reveals similar negative effects supporting obesity. They found out that mice feed with high fructose food developed leptin resistance. Leptin is the hormone, secreted by fat cells, that tells the brain that the stomach is full. The presence of high fructose alters the way leptin works, fooling the brain so that it ignores leptin, resulting to binge eating and ultimately obesity. Although there are other causes of leptin resistance like environmental chemical hazards, EDCs, high fructose intake takes a significant ground. These studies are dreadful reminders that added sugars rich in fructose should be avoided at all cost to have a significant and lasting weight management. If you're like many people, you're probably eating and drinking more sugar than you realize because it's added to so many foods and beverages. Added sugars add calories without adding nutrients. Added sugars are the sugars and syrups added to foods during processing. Desserts, sodas, and energy and sports drinks are the top sources of added sugars for most Americans, but many other foods contain added sugars. You may know there's added sugar in your Coke, cookies, or ice creams. But did you know that it's in your salad dressing, Greek yogurt, and green smoothies? Sweetness has an almost universal appeal. So adding sugar to processed foods makes them more appetizing. Why are added sugars a problem? Foods with a lot of added sugars contribute extra calories to your diet but provide little nutritional value. In addition, added sugars are often found in foods that also contain solid fats, such as butter or margarine, or shortening in baked goods. Adding sugar to foods and beverages makes them more calorie dense. In addition, it's easy to consume extra calories when eating foods that are sugar sweetened. The 2015-2020 Dietary Guidelines for Americans recommend that added sugars make up no more than 10% of your daily calories. For a 2,000-calorie diet, that means no more than 200 calories a day should come from added sugars. That's about 12 teaspoons or 48 grams of sugar. To put these numbers into perspective, 1 teaspoon of sugar, which equals about 4 grams, has about 16 calories. A 12-ounce can of regular soda has about 160 calories, about 10 teaspoons or 40 grams of sugar. Therefore, a can of soda is all you must have to meet the recommended daily sugar requirement. Identifying added sugars can be confusing. The nutrition facts label on packaged foods and drinks currently displays the total amount, in grams, of all sugars found in a serving of the product. This number includes both natural and added sugars. Ingredients are listed in descending order by weight. If you see sugar listed among the first few ingredients, the product is likely to be high in added sugars. Sugar goes by many different names, depending on its source and how it was made. This can also make it hard to identify added sugars, even when you read ingredient lists and food labels. Check for ingredients ending in O's, that's the chemical name for many types of sugar, such as fructose, glucose, maltose and dextrose. Here's a list of other common types of added sugars. Cane juice and cane syrup. Corn sweeteners and high fructose corn syrup. Fruit juice concentrate and nectars. Honey. Malt or maple syrup. Molasses. Let's run down some commonly consumed food and drinks that contains hidden sugar, starting from ones with not so much per serving size to those with staggering amounts. Foods containing 1/4 to 1/2 teaspoon of sugar per serving. 1 teaspoon of French's honey mustard. 1 teaspoon of Lee and Perrins Worcestershire sauce. 2 tablespoons of Mission medium chunky salsa. 1 tablespoon of Miracle Whip. Foods containing 1 teaspoon sugar per serving. 1 tablespoon of Heinz sweet relish. 1 tablespoon of Heinz ketchup. Foods containing 2 teaspoons sugar per serving. 2 tablespoons of Ken's fat-free raspberry pecan dressing. 1 cup Greek yogurt. Foods containing 3 teaspoons sugar per serving. 1 cup Silk original almond milk. 2 tablespoons of Sweet Baby Ray's original barbecue sauce. 2 tablespoons of Nesquik milk chocolate. 1 cup of non-fat milk in latte. Foods containing 4 to 6 teaspoons sugar per serving. A Pink Lady apple juice. 1 Builder's protein bar. 1 cup Nature Valley oats and honey granola. Foods containing 6 to 8 teaspoons sugar per serving. 500 milliliters of Lipton iced tea, peach flavor. 600 milliliters Powerade, lemon lime. Foods containing 13 teaspoons sugar per serving. 15 ounces Naked green smoothie. 12 ounces Odwalla green smoothie. How to cut on added sugar. Number 1. Stop drinking sugary drinks. Wean yourself slowly if going cold turkey is too much to bear. Number 2. Keep away from temptations. Clean up your house and skip the supermarket's aisles for junk foods entirely. Number 3. Cut your kids' contact. But don't be overreact, or the forbidden fruit will be even more appealing. Number 4. Be suspicious of any foods in boxes, bags, and cans. Don't be fooled, organic, natural, and other healthy-sounding products, more often than not contains hidden sugars. Always read the labels. Number 5. Create a healthy community. Could your workplace, your gym, or your kids' school take a stand for healthier choice? But if you already have leptin resistance, if you have difficulties in curbing your appetite, if you can't lose that bulges despite all other means, then try a natural, high antioxidant food supplement that made the obese wife of the maker lose 62 pounds in 21 days. The name is Leptitox, marketed only online. Check the link below if you are interested to know more about Leptitox.